nothing to do with touching.
Thank you.
I would like to welcome you all today to St. Patrick's Kinnaleg to celebrate the wedding of Elizabeth Agnes and James Price. I invite you to declare your intention to take on this sentence for the rest of your life. Who gave this woman to be married to me?
I do! Elizabeth Agnes, you take this gentleman to be your wife, because he's great prophet. He has 40 heads and 50 ducks. And he has two bags of more corporate ahadura ball. And that's the cat. And you know, you never see a poor day for the rest of your life. So take him, Elizabeth Agnes, in the name of God.
I will marry him if you say so.
That's the girl.
Elizabeth Agnes, do you take this man, James Pius, as your husband, for better, for worse? For richer, for poorer, for the Footmud Bank, and hopefully, in a year's time, the children's allowance.
I do only if he stays at home with me at night and not rattle.
James Pius, do you take that pride and joy, Elizabeth Agnes, for your wife? For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, for looking after you all the days of your life.
I do, if she lays down on my behalf.
You have declared your consent before families and friends, some who have come from overseas. Who has the ring?
Harry,
the ring, please.
I don't
know.
Elizabeth Agnes, wear this ring as a sign that you will have everything ready for me when I want it. I give you this ring.
The silver.
This gold and silver. That'll be the last thing you will get for a long time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Now that I have joined this couple in marriage, we should live happily ever after.
Thank you.
according to the matchmaking. Wasn't it the lucky day, James Pyatt, when you were going to the bar and you spotted Elizabeth Agnes at Dermot's Bridge selling tickets to the Flowerman? And you took a fancy to her there and then, and the miller made the match, God bless him. Your response is, more power to the miller.
More power! In Dr. Plunkett's hotel in the next. Response, more power to the miller.
More power to the miller!
Yippee! Yippee!
Woo!
Now, we will have to pay him the pay for it.
Now that Elizabeth Arden and James Pyatt are joined together, let no hens or ducks ever come between them. Can you hear us?
Yes,
we hope that the bride and groom will have a good fire on them and no burnt shins. Get here.
Yes, all of you.
May the knot that you put on today with your tongue never lose. Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Now we'll all sit down, please, and for the rest there is time. I invite you both to sign the register.
Yes.
sake, huh?
Where's your raven? Oh, come on, Johnny, you do the raven. You have another one in your pocket. You have? You have, of course. Did I put anything on with the ring?
can't join a better woman on you.
And the mother of the groom, Annie. The father of the groom, Charlie, and the mother of the bride, Mary.
And an even more enjoyable honeymoon.
Thank you. Congratulations on your big day. When this you see, remember me. When on the page you found, remember the one who spoiled your book by writing upside down. James Wallace, Copenhagen.
Job now to welcome James Pyers into our family and to tell him that he's getting one of the best girls in the parish of Crushelock. She'll feed the hens and the ducks, she'll milk the cows, she'll even turn the turf in the bog. But she was always used to being out at the weekends and getting a drink. And seeing the main old devil that James Pyers is, I hope he changes and brings her out. Because only for all the wealth he had, she'd never have married him today. But James Pyers, I expect to get her in Lovat next Saturday night and every Saturday night in the years to come. And Elizabeth, if he doesn't bring you in, you're always welcome back, because there's a lot of them doing it nowadays anyway. So we don't want you to be treated bad. So that's, nearly all I'd have to say, only just to tell you a little funny story. I think I told her before often about the way weddings does change nowadays. You see, when I seen Terry there trying to make a bargain with the priest and he got away at £4.50, I used to hear my grandfather saying that the priest that married them years ago only got 5 bob. But there was a story told about a fellow in the lower end of the parish of Crushelock, and he married a girl from the parish of Den. And they got married in Den anyway, and at that time the reception would be at home in the bride's house. So they went home and had a bit of grub and drunk a couple of bottles of Guinness and did that the next morning, of course. Anyway, they used to go to Mass and Cross Keys, and the groom, he had no business up to Crushelock till the following spring. He came up to pay his dues and his oath money. At that time, the priest way of travelling was on horseback, and the people of the parish had to supply those for the horse or money. So I wonder what Billy Johnny hadn't or Father Ned had the horse. But anyway, he came up anyway to Crushelaw, and the priest says to him, "It's a terrible pass," he says, "that you're 6 months married, and I never had the pleasure of meeting your wife. I wish to God, says Pat, that I had your story to tell, the ones that get known too well. But the fought away all through life anyway, but they never separated. And Pat died first. And you know the way it is with the women when we die, you know, they have a horrid sorrow for afterwards, you know. She was telling everyone that come in to the wake about the last words he spoke. And she says, "Is there any request you want, Pat Grady?" And he says, "Just leave me behind, Agnes." And at that, she says, the poor fellow turned his head to the wall and he died like a saint. That's all. I hope John Crowe won't do that.
And now we'll call on Terry to read more telegram.
Your Elizabeth, Agnes and James Pyatt. Take it handy on the first night, and if you get it handy, take it twice. And James Pyatt and Elizabeth Agnes, eat lots of bread and jam to give you strength to push the pram. From Terry and Gillian. To Elizabeth Agnes and James Pyatt, best wishes. Weather fine and close at first, a little suddenly. Congratulations on your wedding day. Good night and good nipping. Think of me when you're slipping. I mean on the close name and not in the bed, Johnny Dooley Birmingham. Congratulations to Elizabeth and James. There was a time in you, you're not a happy time for me, but since my eyes beheld your face, my mind was never free. I love you better than you know, more dear the words can tell. And if you find a fault in me, it's fault you for loving you too well. Jay and Michael Canada. Thank you.
Hello,
bride and groom. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the happiest days of my life. I never was as happy since the day I got married myself, because I discovered that my son was getting married to a very decent girl who has a very decent father and mother. And I didn't know until this morning that Tom and I had something very much in common, and we had. Because back years ago, when we had a good football team in Crushelaw, Tom was the club chairman and I was the team coach. And we worked together through all them years and we won 7 county champions in a row. And we're here and ready and willing to cope with all things that happened between James Pius and Elizabeth Agnes. We'll be able to settle any little disputes, and you never know where disputes arise with a married couple. However, I'm not going to delay any longer, or I hope there'll never be any disputes, but I got a little message in the post yesterday morning that I have to read for the bride, for the groom. This is from your workmates in the County Offaly in Bordnamona, and it says, "May your beef and beer increase each year, and your wages never go down, and your dear little wife be the pride of your life and never kick up her at it, and do all she can to help the old man that wore the tough man's jacket." Thank you, ladies.
And now we call on Father Kate to say a few words.
Good morning, my own. Now, when I first met Elizabeth Agnes and James Pyatt, it's some 10 years ago. I have known them for that length of time. I was in their parish for a short time, and after about 4 years, I got a bit of promotion but I never lost touch with my old parish. So about 6 months ago to the day, there was a knock on the door, and my housekeeper went to it, and they asked for Father Ned. So she welcomed them in and brought them into the sitting room. Then she came in to where I was in my study, writing, and she told me there were two guests to see me. So I come on to the sitting room door and just knocked, and they said, come in. And when I opened the door, I was delighted to see my two friends sitting down. So I welcomed them with open arms. And later on, the housekeeper brought in some tea to the three of us. And over that cup of tea, they told me of their mission. They said they were getting married on the 25th of June and asked me if I would come and perform the wedding ceremony.
And then the band played and they all